Nice.
We have gathered here on the International Quds Day, observed throughout the world to show solidarity with the people of Palestine and to condemn all the atrocities carried out by the Zionists. Unfortunately, after 70 long years, we still need to do this. We all have seen the recent images of Gaza, where oppressed people putting up a meager resistance and posing almost no threat were gunned down, resulting in dozens dead and thousands wounded. This is just another link in this long, brutal occupation. As a part of a rabbinic delegation, I myself visited Gaza twice since the siege, and we can bear testimony to the massive destruction of buildings and infrastructure and the suffering of innocent people, including women and children. Families are living in simple, flimsy tents all four seasons of the year. We are embarrassed when the Zionists commit all their crimes, supposedly in our name, and it is a desecration of our religion when they misuse verses of the Holy Torah to justify their criminal actions. According to Judaism, the Zionist movement is heresy, and all its atrocities are forbidden. Masses of Jewish people worldwide oppose this, including people in the Holy Land. The philosophy of Zionism to organize the Jewish people with political power is contrary to Judaism. Judaism stands for belief in the Almighty and the observance of His commandments. We accept the Jewish exile as a divine decree. It is God's requirement that we be loyal citizens in the countries where we reside, to live in peace with our neighbors and not to rebel against any nation. Jewish leadership and their followers for the past 2,000 years have never attempted to create a sovereign homeland and never committed crimes against anyone. The movement of Zionism was invented by Theodor Herzl and his comrades, people who were outspoken heretics and didn't follow anything of the Jewish religion. Secular politicians of Jewish descent are showing their ignorance and foolishness when they quote the Jewish religion in support of the Zionist movement, which is in total contradiction to Judaism. We condemn the occupation. We will never accept the state of Israel. We want you to know that we cry and our hearts are rent by the suffering of the Palestinians. We want you to know that we stand up and demonstrate with the Palestinians, and we say that their claim is right. There should be immediately a free Quds, a free Gaza, and a free Palestine. We must save the people of Gaza. We must give them relief, and not just talk of relief. A total relief with a speedy and peaceful end to the entire occupation. There must be a speedy and peaceful end to the occupation of Quds and Jerusalem. We hope and pray that all wrongs should be righted in accordance with the Almighty's will. We want to return to that true peace that existed in Palestine prior to the Zionist provocation. Just like in other Muslim countries, Jews in Palestine coexisted in harmony with the majority non-Jewish population. Clearly, the reason for today's dispute is not the difference of religion, because despite their differences of religion, Muslims, Jews, and others lived in Palestine for well over a millennium, in peace and in harmony. We respected and protected each other. Unfortunately, ever since Zionists came into being, until this day, for over 100 years, there has been an endless river of bloodshed of Muslims, of Christians, and of Jews. And we point our fingers at the Zionists and we say, your hands are covered in blood. You have created this conflict. You have stolen the land from the Palestinians. You oppress them to this day. You are the root cause of all this bloodshed from both sides. Peoples of all backgrounds were living together in harmony before you came. You are the interloper. You are the foreign body that is invading our peaceful existence. Without Zionism, we all could work together and coexist in peace. We, Jewish people, have gone through many sufferings in our long history of exile. We know what pain is like, and we don't want to see suffering inflicted on other people. As we speak here, there are delegations of Jewish communities in Kutz Day, events in many other cities in the United States, in Canada, and in England, in Belgium, and in Germany, in total solidarity with Palestine, condemning Zionist atrocities and clarifying that the State of Israel does not represent world Jewry or the Holy Torah or the Jewish religion. We appreciate the Palestinians who have hosted Jewish people for centuries, and so too do we appreciate the United States of America for granting us freedom of religion and for the concern of its leaders for the Jewish people. We appreciate world leaders who express sympathy with the Jewish people, but we are truly concerned with their help for Jews causes a loss to others, as well as danger to the Jews themselves. We would like to clarify that even if support to Israel was beneficial to Jews, it should not be done at the expense of another people. But in fact, support to Israel is not beneficial to the Jewish people or to the Jewish religion. The existence of the State of Israel and all its criminal acts are serious violations of Judaism and causing danger not just to Palestinians, but also to the Jewish people. In regards to the recent controversy over Jerusalem, I would like to state that authentic Jewry never recognized the existence of the State of Israel, and therefore we cannot and will not accept Jerusalem as its capital. We demand a totally free Palestine, and we want to see all rights restored to the Palestinian people, including the full right of return. Ultimately, we pray for the final redemption, when, as we say in our prayers, all wickedness will disappear, and all of humanity will join together to worship God in harmony. Amen. Thank you very much.
Akbar!
Allahu Akbar! Allah.